be here today. Thank you all so much for having me. So, when we were asked to send a speaker to come today, I leapt at the chance, not only because I loved the wonderful city of Liverpool, but because I knew that by coming here, I'd learn a lot about similar struggles that both communities have endured. I have to say, though, the last time I was in Liverpool was on a hen night. We had the best time. I lost a phone and a shoe. But the city welcomed us with open arms. And ever since Grenfell wanted to return, the support that we've had has been incredible. And Liverpool was one of the first places to do a solidarity march. So thank you so much for that. So I had to look at the panel we have here today, and I tried to think about what I could offer to you. This is a really incredible panel, and they have a wealth of knowledge. They've been back there just when I'm like, but I haven't been doing this for too long. I've only been campaigning since October. Before that, the last speaking event I had was in secondary school in maths. So this is all very new to me. I hope I don't bore you. I thought that the best thing I could bring today was my knowledge of the community that I've grown up in, a little before the fire, and how it's been following the fire. So firstly, and most importantly, there has been no justice. 72 people have died. I say 72 because in January, the 72nd person died. She spent months in the hospital from the Grenfell Tower fire. Hundreds have been displaced, thousands are suffering from trauma, and still there is no justice. So if we go back to November 2016, when the Grenfell Action Group wrote on their blog, "It is a truly terrifying thought that the Grenfell Action Group firmly believe that only a catastrophic event will expose the ineptitude of our landlord, their sordid collusion with the RBKC Council is a recipe for a future major disaster." It continues, "The Grenfell Action Group predicts that it won't be long before the words of this blog come back to haunt the KC TMO management. They can't say they weren't warned." Residents of Grenfell had their voices muted. They made petitions, they organised protests, they rallied around, they wrote to the TMO and the council numerous times, but they were ignored. In 2013, the Grenfell Action Group was threatened with legal action by the council in a bid to stop the group criticising them, saying that such criticism amounted to defamation and harassment. At 54 minutes past midnight on the 14th of June, the first emergency call came in. Within 15 minutes, the building was up in flames, with hundreds of people trapped inside, and the tower burned for more than 60 hours. The days following were shambles, and whilst the City of London and the community united, and the rest of the UK organised and rallied around to help those in need, the council and the government were eerily missing. There was no response by authorities, by the fire brigade and the peace service. Our community was inundated with reporters trying to make the next news piece, but no council response for days. Some residents of the tower weren't even left to sleep on the floor's local sports centre for over a week. Theresa May then promised that all residents would be rehoused within 3 weeks. Months later, Sajid Javid said it would be a year. So where are we now? Nearly 11 months later, fast approaching the anniversary, and before Sajid Javid was promoted, he said that the rehousing process will take longer than a year. As of today, 72 households from the tower, not including the surrounding evacuated walkways, are still in an emergency accommodation, be that B&B or hotel. 64 households are still in temporary accommodation. We learned 2 months ago that on each floor of Grenfell Tower, there were rooms with no fire damage, and that had been unaffected by the smoke, and they were bin rooms that led to the bin chutes. We learned last month that there had been 24 suicide attempts since Grenfell, though I'm pretty sure the number is much higher. We know that the NHS has implemented a plan to reach 23,000 people in our community who may be suffering from PTSD. The tower is still 11 months on, not completely covered, which adds to the trauma many in our community feel each day. When people used to walk past Grenfell, they'd think, "My mum's at home, my best friend's there, my aunt is at home," because they could see the lights on. And now all of the lights are off. And we're reminded each day about the horrific night. We also know that only 7 other buildings around the UK have been decladded. 300 or so were tested, they all failed. And these aren't actually the privately owned buildings. We have no idea how many of those have flammable cladding and insulation on them. Whatever the number, the response has been embarrassingly inadequate, and there's a hell of a lot of people who are who are at risk of their homes, schools, hospitals, etc., becoming the next Grenfell Tower. What's to come is my next point. The inquiry is due to open again on the 21st of May. It will start with memorials for all those that died. Although the inquiry has a starting date, there's still a big fight to be had. On the 14th of May, MPs will debate whether the inquiry should be led by a diverse and equal decision-making panel, which is what the survivors, bereaved, and community want. Theresa May has already said no to this. And then we had a little bit of help from Stormzy, which allowed us to have the day in Parliament. What a date they chose. The 14th of May is the 11th month anniversary. And they knew what they were doing when they made this day. On the 14th of May, we will be protesting outside Parliament. Then we'll head back to Grenfell for a monthly silent walk. And of course, on the 14th of June is the anniversary. There are a lot of things planned during this weekend. We'll be announcing some of our plans tomorrow, so please do check our Twitter page and website. And also, we will be launching a campaign next week in regards to the inquiry deck, so it would be very useful if you can get on Twitter and retweet and put that out for you there. We've got some really interesting things coming up, and we'd love for as many of you to be involved as you can. All I would ask is that you keep talking about to anyone that will listen. The best forever to be not now, just keep talking about Grenfell. We can't let this slide, we won't let this go. And as with our Billboards campaign, we must keep Grenfell in the public eye. We've got to keep talking about it. We must keep the story going. And we must be the voices for those who can't use their own anymore. 72 people died. Several suicide attempts, hundreds displaced, hundreds still homeless, thousands living in unsafe buildings, thousands traumatised, no diverse decision-making panel, the tower is still not covered, 72 people died, and still we have no justice.